Right now, what sheriff's deputies and fire personnel are doing is they're going door to door, knocking on doors, trying to make contact with those in the immediately affected area to find out, are the occupants inside those homes, are they okay? Were they affected by the gas? We want to be sure if somebody was sleeping with the windows open last night that they're safe, because this is a silent gas, so to speak. People can inhale this and not know and become quickly unconscious. So we're checking on their well-being. There were two sheriff's deputies transported to the hospital. They're in stable condition. A Zion police officer was also transported to the hospital. My understanding is he's in stable condition as well.
And yeah, just reiterating that we're not getting any reports of an accident. It looked like these tanks leaked because of a failure of the tank itself. As of right now, we have gone to our life safety box. We exhausted, right? We're in Division 4. So we went to the fifth alarm, which is the most. We got ambulances here. We actually went interdivisional to Division 3, which is in Cook County. You'll see some of their ambulances here. So we're working with about 25 ambulances shuttling people through. As you see, the ambulances come back. They've dropped off a patient at the hospital, and then they've come back to the scene, and they report back to staging. The leak has stopped. The issue is the plume of gas now. I mean, the liquid leaks or solid, those are a little bit easier to contain and dike off. This is harder, something that's airborne, so they're kind of monitoring it. Our hazardous material technicians are in there. They're dressed with much more appropriate gear than just even fire turnout gear. They've got monitors. They're checking air quality. They're getting into homes, checking the same things.